Hi, it's Kiffin Lo Bates here, and a couple of years ago I made a video briefly outlining how you could get started on becoming a blockchain programmer. Now, a lot of things have changed since then, and most of the activity, from what I can tell, is in the smart contract space, particularly in Ethereum compatible blockchains. So I thought I would make a video giving a swift introduction as to where you can go in order to become a smart contract programmer or a Web3 programmer. And it's kind of important to understand both, I think, because the whole system is quite tightly interconnected. So firstly, smart contracts. Well, the language you need to know there is Solidity. Solidity is a JavaScript-like language. So if you already know JavaScript, that'll give you a bit of a head start. But it also has some kind of, C-like properties to it as well, because it's a bit lower level than JavaScript, and you don't have all these packages and modules that you can pull in. Except you kind of do, because there's an organization out there called Open Zeppelin, and they provide lots of templates for standard types of smart contract. For example, ERC20 tokens and ERC721 tokens. That's fungible tokens and non-fungible tokens, and a bunch of supporting libraries that help you write secure smart contract code. So Open Zeppelin would be your first starting point there. You're also going to need a development environment. The one I like the most is called Hardhat. It seems to be gaining the most traction, and the guys over there seem to be pretty responsive to requests for feature enhancements and stuff like that. So that gives you your development environment. And that should be enough to get you started on writing some smart contracts and deploying them out onto one of the Ethereum-like blockchains out there. So that's the back-end stuff, writing smart contracts. If you're going to write front-end stuff, well, we're talking about Web3 here, producing web pages that interact with the blockchain. And at the moment, the way that these websites function is typically going through something known as a provider. This is a service that connects you to the back-end blockchain. You can think of the blockchain like a database, and you need some kind of connective code that allows your web page to talk to it. So it's very similar in that respect to normal website programming, where the website is stored in a database and you pull out the relevant bits in order to bring up the information on the screen. Now, again, there are a number of different providers out there. The one that I like to use the most happens to integrate neatly with wallet software. So the most popular wallet out there at the moment appears to be Metamask. It's a plugin that you can install in your browser, and you can write web pages that will actually talk to that web wallet, and through it have access to make queries to your blockchain that you've chosen, and also to send transactions to it, with the user being able to sign them using their wallet. So Metamask is the thing that you need to visit there. Now, most of the coding that takes place to do this kind of stuff is done through Node.js, and there are a bunch of packages out there that you can install with NPM, such as Ethers.js or Web3.js. They provide you with the functionality to be able to make these calls to the blockchain to get information back, or to send information to the blockchain, or through the proxy method of using Metamask. So that's the kind of next step to actually building a front end that allows people to interact with the smart contract that you deployed if you did the first lot of stuff that I talked about. And then you need to have knowledge of a web framework as well. So there are things out there like React, or in fact, one I like a lot at the moment is Node.js. It pulls in a bunch of other pieces quite nicely, uses React. It also can use Tailwind, which is a CSS library for making your site look nice, and so on and so forth. And there are lots of tutorials out there in order to get you started with that too. You just need to Google them or search for them using your search engine of choice. So really, that's the whole stack from the bottom all the way up to the top. I hope that's helped some of you budding programmers out there to get started. I'll put a list of these things in the comments below, and with any luck, after a day or two of following some tutorials on the web, you'll be launching your own smart contract and putting up your website to allow people to interact with it. I hope this has been useful to some of you, and I'll see you all in the next video soon. Bye for now.